Hello and welcome to our channel Forensic Science Public Desk India, and I'm here with your topic now with sexual offences, and this is part 1. So Forensic Medicine Lecture 3, Introduction Part 2, Sexual Offences, and this is according to the UGC NET Forensic Science syllabus. So without any late, let's proceed into the topic introduction. Sexual violence definition. Any sexual act, attempt to obtain sexual act, unwanted sexual comments or advances or acts to traffic or otherwise directed against a person's sexuality using coercion by any person regardless of their relationship to victim in any setting including but not limited to home or work. So all these things whatever are said in these definitions, that means you cannot even commit or you cannot talk regarding the sexual content or sexual things, regardless whether it is home or work or they are working under you or they are something very lean, whatever it can be. So anything related to sexual and without the consent, without the will, without a proper communication between two persons, it is done, then it can be regarded as sexual offense. So very simple word, violence, you can understand. So it need not to be a intercourse, it can be a verbal thing also. Okay, coming to sexual assault, could include anything from touching another person's body in sexual way without the person's consent to forced sexual intercourse. Either it can be oral or anal sexual acts or child molestation, fondling, attempted rape. So these are assault, means it is coming to the physical activity, a act which is done. Either it can be touching the person in a sexual way. In a sexual way means you can understand it. So in that particular way, if it is done, then it can be called as sexual assault. And the person who is been as victim can claim a case and they can report it to the police officers. So this is about the introduction. You have to understand two basic terms, that is sexual offense and sexual assault. What are various types of sexual offenses? So we can classify sexual offenses into four basic types. One is natural sexual offenses. Second one is unnatural sexual offenses. And third one is sexual perversions. Fourth one is other sex related offenses. So basically all these things are having very good definitions. You can easily understand this. So let's proceed further and see the definitions and what are various kinds of sexual offenses which are coming under these categories. First one, natural sexual offenses. It includes those offenses which are committed in order of nature, that is by penetration of the vagina by the penis. So this is natural. Sexual intercourse between male and female is natural, but if it is done without the consent, without the will of any of the partner, can be regarded as the rape. You have already understood the rape. And if you are seeing about incest, incest means sexual intercourse by a man with a woman who is closely related to him by blood or by marriage, or you can say the examples like a daughter, granddaughter, sister, stepsister or aunt or anybody else who are in blood relation with the person. So this can be regarded as the incest or incest relationship. Then next we are having adultery. Voluntary sexual intercourse between a married man and someone other than his wife, or between a married woman and someone other than her husband, can be regarded as adultery. Having sexual intercourse with someone who is not his or her legally wedded spouse can be called as adultery. So we are having IPC sections for adultery as well. 497, which will be giving punishment up to 5 years, and 498 IPC section will be giving up to punishment of 2 years. So these two sections will be dealing with adultery. Unnatural sexual offenses. Sexual intercourse against the order of the nature can be regarded as unnatural sexual offenses. So how it can be said? When the act does not involve penetration of a woman's vagina by the man's penis, can be said as unnatural. So it can be in any form of sexual intercourse which does not have the potential of procreation. So if you see the examples, you will be understanding it well. First one, again you are seeing the rape. So after recent amendment, rape is also included in unnatural sexual offenses, where the sexual intercourse is done without the will, without the consent of the woman, can also be regarded as unnatural now. So next we are having sodomy. So by this you can clearly understand what would be the unnatural one. It is the anal intercourse between two males or male and female. So basically it is a anal sex. If it is done, then its name it can be regarded as sodomy. So if it is done between two males, then it is called as homosexual sodomy, and if it is done between two male and female, it can be regarded as heterosexual sodomy. And the heterosexual sodomy is also named as buggery. Okay, then we are having tribadism or lesbianism. So tribadism means it is female homosexuality in which two women by mutual acts of sexual indulgence achieve gratification. So the sex which is done basically between two women can be regarded as tribadism or lesbianism. And we are having bestiality. So bestiality means it is between the human and the animal. So it is sexual intercourse with animal, either vaginal, anal or oral. This includes all animals including birds, the usual victims being the pets like dogs, cats and farm animals like cows, buffaloes and calves, etc. can also be seen in bestiality. So and next we are having buccal coitus. Buccal coitus means penile or vaginal oral sexual intercourse and can be performed by both male and females can be regarded as buccal coitus. So this particular sexual offenses are most important. Many times these are been asked in our UGC net. They will be giving match the following kind of question. They will be giving all these particular terms on a side, and other they will be giving small definitions. Rape means unwillingness without consent having sexual intercourse. Sodomy means it is done between male and female or female male, etc. Whatever it can be, homosexual or heterosexual, anal intercourse it is, okay. And lesbianism is between two females. Bestiality it means human and animal. Buccal coitus means doing with oral. Okay, these particular things you have to remember. Sexual perversions are conditions in which sexual excitement or orgasm is associated with acts or imagery that are considered unusual, abnormal or deviant within the culture. So you all know what is the human culture, what is the human behavior, how it is natural, how it is unnatural. Because of the few other slides we have understood what is unnatural. So there are few other taboo kind of things which can be seen, like sexual perversions. So rape, again it is included in sexual perversions as well. So again we are having sadism, masochism. So let's see one by one what are those. And rape, you already know, without the will and without the consent of the woman, if it is done, it need not to be penetration now in this case. It can be the touching or it can be any other act which has been done or against woman, then it can be called as the rape. So this is the expansion of the rape definition now. So let's clearly have the definition of rape again. So coming to sadism, person gets sexual gratification by infliction of pain or physical cruelty, like beating, biting, whipping, cigarette burns or ill-treating the partner can be seen in the sadism. So sadism between the male and female in a usual, in a natural way may not be possible. But if this particular behavior is seen, that means sexual gratification by inflicting pain to other person is seen, then it is completely unnatural. There is a small malfunction in the sexuality of a person. So what is the masochism? Sexual gratification is obtained only when they receive painful stimulus from opposite partner. So sadism is showing the pain to the opposite partner. Masochism is self-inflicting the pain. That means he is taking or she is taking the pain from their partner. So that is called as masochism. Then we are having transvestic fasticism. This particular thing is, it can be called as a disorder characterized by recurrent intense sexual arousing fantasies. Sexual urges or behaviors include cross-dressing. That means wearing female's dress by a male, or a female wearing the male's dress. So this kind of behavior can be said as transvestic fetishism. And coming to exhibitionism, you can see it is a desire and intentional exposure of genitalia. It can be the penis, it can be the any other genitalia part, that can be the breast or it can be the vagina, etc. in public places, while in presence of others, mostly in front of unsuspected children or females, to obtain sexual pleasure. So generally this exhibitionism is seen in males. So they are showing their genitalia in public to a female, focusing to a female or children, can be said as exhibitionism. And we can see voyeurism here. So there is a morbid desire of the individual to observe unsuspecting people undress or getting naked, taking bath. So seeing their genitalia or watching somebody having intercourse to get erotic excitement and sexual gratification can be said as voyeurism. And we are having the other definition of fetishism. So transvestic, you have seen, that is the wearing others' gender dresses. And in normal fetishism, you can see it is a fixation on an inanimate object or body part that is not primarily sexual in nature, and the compulsive need for its use in order to obtain sexual gratification. So it need not to be a opposite sexual person. It can be anything. It can be any object. Any object, if they are putting their sexual genitalia towards it and they are getting the sexual gratification, then it can be called as fetishism. And futurism, it is the act of obtaining sexual arousal and gratification by rubbing of one's genitals against the non-consenting person in public places. So you can understand this will be happening in the public places where males especially are rubbing their genitalia towards the females who are in the crowd or who are in the traveling buses or trains, something kind of things. So this type of offenses will also occur, in which the female can claim and she can complain, she can report to the police as well. So this is also one of the sexual offense. So last one of sexual perversions, we can see the masturbation. Masturbation is the deliberate self-stimulation which results in sexual arousal or sexual gratification. Masturbation is common in both male and female. So in males, you can see methods are mostly manual, by moving the penis with hand or against the bed or any other object. In females, a finger or a hand is gently rhythmically moved over the clitoris. So these are various sexual perversions, and let's proceed with other sexual related offenses. Other sex linked offenses. Sexual harassment. Sexual harassment is defined as physical contact and advances involving unwelcome and explicit sexual overtures or demanding sexual favors, showing pornography against her will, or making sexually colored remarks, which will be punishable to 1 to 3 years. And if you are seeing indecent assault, any unwanted sexual behavior or touching of a female without her consent, with the intention or knowledge to outrage her modesty, can be regarded into the indecent assault. So it is punishable under section 354. And if there is another way of understanding this thing, any man who assaults or uses criminal force on any woman or abets such act with intention of disrobing or compelling her to be naked is punishable with the imprisonment 3 to 7 years. Coming to the stalking. So stalking is also punishable. If you understand this stalking, the crime of illegally following and watching someone over a period of time, in this particular case, it will be a female generally followed and observed her activities by a male for sexual offense, and to plan a sexual offense, such kind of thing. So again, it will be coming under 354D section, which will be punished up to 1 to 3 years. Recent amendments of sexual offenses. As per the recent Criminal Law Amendment Act 2013, rape is no longer considered as a natural sexual offense. It has been expanded its definition of rape to natural sexual offenses, unnatural sexual offenses as well. So it is also been seen in our study that it is also part of sexual perversion. So it can be any activity which involves oral anal, objects, weapons, fingers, touching, and all these are included in our rape laws. Hence, rape can be natural, unnatural sexual intercourse, or perversion, or combination of all these three. So, the law recognized the right to treatment for all survivors, victims of sexual offense, sexual violence by public and private healthcare facilities. Failure to treat these particular victims or survivors of rape is now regarded as an offense under this particular law. So, this is included in the basic doctor duties. So, whoever it can be, the rape victim or rape survivor is reaching to a medical facility and she is approaching to RMP doctor, registered medical practitioner, then his primary duty is to give preference to the rape victim among all the patients. Other than exceptional case, when is another patient who is in life-threatening case. So, if any patient is there whose life is going to end without the treatment, in that particular case only the doctor should be giving preference to other patient. Other than that, main primary preference should be given to the rape victim. So, the law further disallows any reference to past sexual practices of the survivors. So, they cannot judge anything. They have to give the treatment as per the norms. They have to collect the all forensic evidences relevant with the rape. So, this is the video on introduction part of sexual offenses. Hope you have understood the concepts and the classification of various sexual offenses. In next video, we are going to learn about the rape and other sexual offenses and unnatural sexual offenses as well, and laws related to rape and other unnatural sexual offenses. Thank you for watching this video. Please support us.